up, everybody? Rocky Mountain Figures here, and today is finally the big day. Why do I look so white in the camera view? There you go, I'm a little darker. Anyway, today is the big day. Finally, we are going to be doing a display update video for May 2020. I've been teasing this for a long time. I've been giving you guys updates, and even in my past videos, I've had this type of camera view. And you guys have probably noticed that the shelves were filling up and filling up and filling up. But finally, today is the day. I'm finally ready to show you guys what my collection looks like now. Also, I hope I don't get in trouble for using the end credit song from Daredevil Season 3 by John Pisano. I hope Netflix doesn't take me down. I mean, they didn't take down Wallop and Web Snapper for using the Defenders theme song, right? Also, my inspiration for doing that intro was from him and watching his collection update that just recently went on his channel. Make sure you go check out his channel. You know, he's a great guy and he does a lot of awesome customs, so make sure you go check him out. Props to Netflix, John Pisano, and Daredevil Season 3. That music was from them. And I got a lot of new things. I changed a lot of stuff. A lot of things will be different from the past update videos. I actually finished my collection, or finished posing them, about like a week and a half ago, but I didn't feel like it was ready because there was still a lot of things missing, such as I got some new puck lights for, you know, this whole part of the room. You guys are not going to see it right now, but where I'm looking at, that whole part of the room, I got some new puck lights, and those puck lights are awesome. I got them on OfferUp for about 10 bucks, and they work amazing. It was 6 puck lights with the remote, this one, and man, I love them so much. We're just going to get down to the nitty-gritty. I'm going to show you everything, starting from that side of the room, working our way to this side of the room. So let's get straight into my collection. Okay, so starting on this side of the room, and if you guys have seen the ring lights, also I'm playing one of my older videos, which in that video I played another older collection update video. Oh yeah, I feel like it'll be cool. Like, look, now we're maybe this video will be in a future collection update video, but it is actually nighttime right now, so that's why you see the ring lights, and that's why I'm only going to focus on one side of the room for now. But if you guys are wondering who was that dog from the beginning of the video, that was my dog Benny right here. He's one viejito, man. He's old, but he's a good boy. Aren't you, Ben? You've been with me all these years, man. You've been with me all these years. Oh, Benny. So cute. So funny. He sits wherever he likes. Yeah. And of course, I got the chair right here to help me, or to help get me boosted up on the shelf. So now let's get started. So the first new addition, or rather two new additions, is this Amiibo Kirby and the Infinity Gauntlet that I got from a fan of my Instagram and YouTube channel. His name is eCollector609. Make sure to give him a follow or a shout out. But thank you, man, for this. I really appreciate it. I'll show what else he got me later on in the video as we go through my whole collection. But this Kirby was from a friend of ours, and this is not mine, this is my brother's. I told him that the first clip of that intro video would be of Kirby. I kept that promise, of course. Over here is where I have my consoles and my Switch and whatnot, which got a little dusty, man. Look at that. That's my extended storage bank for the PlayStation. It's a 1 terabyte. I got that at Walmart for 44 bucks. That was pretty cheap and awesome to get. But this is where my Switch would be, but my brother's currently using it right now. He's letting me use the room, so the Switch will be right here, usually, charging. Or, you know, to put it on the screen. You guys know how a Switch works. It's already been a long time since the Switch came out. I got my modern Fantastic Four over here just because it couldn't fit anywhere. I was actually contemplating whether I should sell it, like, as a lot. But I thought that would be a bad idea, especially since I want to keep the Invisible Woman accessories, you know? And I know somebody's going to complain about that. It doesn't come with the Invisible Woman accessory. So I was like, nah, I'll keep it for now. Maybe I'll sell it in the future. But these are like my posters right here. There's my PlayStation. Now, let's get to the Transformer shelf. I'm going to need a boost up there. But there it is, my Transformer Siege and Earthrise shelf. So I'm going to get up there right now. All right, here we go. There you go. So this is my Siege and Earthrise shelf. Now, before I get to it, as you see, I got some new puck lights, man. These puck lights are awesome. But they were a pain in the butt to set up.
just because the adhesive that it came with just was not sticking to the ceiling, so it kept falling over. And then I decided to use some red tape. I'll post a picture of it on screen right now. It's this is a strong red tape too, but it still kept falling. So then I just decided to stick some thumbtacks through the top because they open up. So I decided to stick some thumbtacks through the top and you know, got them up there. And they've been staying up there for about what, like 4 or 3 days now. So yep, I have faith. So anyway, let's start on this side. I added Trigger Happy up here just because I decided to add the older Titans Return figures because you know, some of the designs are canon to the Earthrise and Siege line or in the comics. So that's why I decided to add them. There's my Starscream, Shockwave, and Soundwave with the minions right there. Then there's Megatron and the beautiful Optimus Prime figure. Man, I love that figure. The one of my favorite figures of the year so far. Then I got Bumblebee, Wheeljack, Sideswipe, Earthrise, Cliffjumper, Ironhide, and the Titans Return Sentinel Prime. I know that design for sure is canon. So yeah, now we're gonna get into this set. Oh, hi, wait, how'd you get in here? Jenny, hey, how'd you get in here? Huh? How'd you get in? She's sneaky though. She will like sneak into my room without me knowing. What she does is she hides in the closet. So I'll show you right now. She hides in the closet under all my clothes in there. And then next thing you know, I'm gonna hear a that's like the sound that she makes, and then she comes out. So I'm gonna turn these lights on. I'm just turning them on right now. So this is a closet, but I also have a, you know, drawer shelf space in here. And this is where I keep my Funko Pops, or Bruno's Funko Pops rather, my brother's. There we go. And then in here, I actually moved all my Nerf guns out of the room except this one. This one couldn't fit in the box that I was trying to put away, that I put all the Nerf guns in there. So I'm keeping this one in here for now. Like, I got this for a future display project right here. I learned about this from Esso Hunter's channel. But I did actually make my very own display, which I'm going to make my own dedicated video on that. It's actually in this box of displays. I'm not sure if I featured in the past collection update videos, but I used to have my displays like scattered everywhere. But now I keep them in this Home Depot box. And I keep them all in there. That is also another project that I worked on that's pretty much finished, that I actually used for a photo recently. So, and of course, in all these drawers, I think I'm always showing you the drawers. In here are my comic books, plus my my gaming stick right here for the Street Fighter fighting games, Marvel's Capcom, BB&E, some snowboard goggles right there, or ski goggles, whatever you want to call them. Then there's all my comic books. I'm not going to show them right now. It would be cool if I did like a comic book update video. This is where I keep my figures for sale. I recently updated my page. I took out a lot of stuff and then put up some of the same stuff, but some newer stuff, you know. I actually did sell my Wolverine. So both of my favorite figures of all time, I did give away, or not give away, but sell. I sold my Siege Optimus Prime and my Tiger Stripe Wolverine from the Apocalypse Wave. So, but I do have these figures right here. And as you see, I got the Baby Yoda. At the time of this recording, I haven't listed this yet, but I'll be sure to list that soon. Here, I'm stuck. I got my Funko Pops for sale. It kind of sucks because, you know, and I always say this, but this is true. My trip down here from Colorado when I was moving back to San Diego, the boxes kind of got damaged, especially this one. So some of the boxes are damaged. I'll let you know if they're damaged. That's why I have them for like cheaper than they normally would, but people still aren't buying. I highly recommend you try to buy some Funko Pops from me because I don't want to keep these ones. Or rather, my brother doesn't want to keep these ones because they're his. He's selling them. Then those are comic books for sale that I don't need, that I'm trying to clear out. And this is like some loose figures in there. Some of them aren't even listed. Actually, I got to list them. I think I took down the listings for those. But anyway, this is the Funko Pop display, my brother's Funko Pop display, or one of them at least. So I've got some anime figures up there. I don't know anything about anime. My brother is getting into it, so he got those pops. And then I got these. But what's funny is you guys are going to get all excited about this, especially that one guy that commented on the video. I hid my cookies in there. I can't really focus because I'm holding the Funko Pops right here. But We got some cookies in there, hiding in there. I usually like to hide my snacks because my family, whenever they see a snack, they just devour and I get none of it. And then they put the blame on me for eating them all. So that's why I started just buying my own snacks and only sharing sometimes, you know, or when I get caught hiding snack. And here I got some Doritos. So there you go. I have no other snacks hiding. Those are just the only two that I have stored. So here are my Star Wars Black Series figures. I'm hoping to get back into the Black Series game, especially since the figures that they've been coming out with are amazing, man. Are just awesome. Especially those 40th anniversary reissues. I love those figures. So we're going to start with this side. This side is all Clone Wars figures. I am not going to be collecting any sequel trilogy figures. I just can't, man. I don't want to. I just did not like the sequel trilogy and how it turned out, so I'm not collecting it. I may be young, but I'm smart enough to know that the sequels are not that good. Personally, I'm an original trilogy fan, man. I grew up with those as a little kid. My parents showed me the movies, so, you know, and I love the prequels too. I grew up on the prequels and Clone Wars, so, you know, there's my Clone Wars shelf. I'm hoping to add some more figures. As you see, it's pretty empty over here and pretty packed on this side. I feel kind of complete on this side, so that's why I want to work on the Clone Wars shelf more. I'm hoping to get that Count Dooku and maybe some Clone Troopers. Man, those Clone Troopers are going for a lot. But anyway, in the back right there, you see I got the Krennic figure and Jyn Erso, the older ones. Hoping they do reissues and I'll sell these off. And there I have my very own Baby Yoda figure for the Mando, the carbonized Mando. I was lucky enough to get one of those on Force Friday. And then I got the Cara Dune right behind her. Right behind him. Oh my goodness. Then I got the old Ben Kenobi right there. Of course, with no face, pretty new tech. But I still think the head sculpt looks okay. Doesn't look bad. It's not the most horrible thing in the world. And I got the 40th anniversary figures. I got the Lando. I love that Lando, man. It's an awesome figure. The Luke Skywalker, Leia, and the Lando right there. Did I just call Han Lando? I think I did. Man, I'm tired, dude. This whole display took me a while. Then I got the Force Awakens Chewbacca. I think there was rumors that there was going to be a Empire 40th anniversary Chewbacca. So if that doesn't come out, I'm gonna get the 2-pack with C-3PO. Now the reason why there's a saber on the floor right here is because I was trying to do a picture with Luke and Vader, and Luke fell off my table while I was doing the picture, and the lightsaber broke. So I have to super glue that back in. But that's why he's like that for now. And speaking of Vader, here he is, man. My favorite villain of all time. I told you I was an original trilogy fan, man. He's my favorite villain of all time. And there's Boba Fett right there. And there's my my Bionicles Vader right there. I don't think it's Bionicles, but it was Lego. And then I got my two, my Qui-Gon and Darth Maul coin bank statues in the back. I did actually have those on my eBay, but I took those down. I thought they'd be way better up there. So now we're going to get into this whole side of the room. I'm just going to switch my light up. Again, it's nighttime. That's why the light is right here. So let's get into it. So now we are going to get into this side of the room, which is the biggest side, of course, as this side, all I had to show was those two stuff right there. We are going to start from here. So right here is where all my remotes and controllers are. Then I got my Clorox wipes right here. Then I did have a candle right here. It did finish today. I'll show you what I used that for. But if I move this right here, I got some figures or some older figures. I got this right here. It's Black Panther bust or coin bank as well. Then I got my old War for Cybertron or Fall of Cybertron rather. Fall of Cybertron figures right here. Then I got some Hot Wheels right here. I got the 1989 Batmobile right here. And then I got the Back to the Future car, the DeLorean. I actually just finished watching all three movies while in quarantine. So that's awesome. And then I got my tumbler right here with the Batman inside. Oh man, this is my one of my childhood toys right here. I've always loved this. It's actually collecting dust right now. Or I didn't mean it to collect dust, but it's got some dust on it. And then I got this Lego car. And he got his Funko Pop DuckTales figure right there. And then right here, my wall of cheap tranza posters right here that I just printed out from my printer and computer. Yeah, man. If you can't afford posters, just get some paper, get your printer, get your computer, and start printing out stuff. That's like the easiest way to do it. This is so ghetto right here, man. But I love it, man. I love what I did. It's kind of like a pyramid. Right here, I got my old Disneyland lightsaber when they used to do like the cheap plastic build the lightsabers, but they were so awesome. Of course, it doesn't have a hilt, but it has a battery in it. And this painting right here, my dad actually won at a giveaway for this painting. He won from his friend. It wasn't staged or anything. You know, J-Ray, he pulled it out of the hat or put all the names that, you know, were entered into this contest out of a hat. And my dad was picked, surprisingly. He's better at giveaways than I am, man. I always lose giveaways, man. I hate that. But I love hosting a giveaway, man. Hosting giveaways fun, dude. Can't wait to hit 1,000 that way and get you guys to a giveaway on my Instagram, not on my YouTube. We're far away from a giveaway on my YouTube, but here are the rest of my posters. These aren't actually printed out. These were from my Storm Collectibles figures, and then the Spider-Man is. And then these are my Disney Store exclusive lightsabers that I also got from Disneyland, and they still work. But as you see, the lights are like broken. Like some of the lights are inside are just burnt out and cracked and whatnot. Which, I didn't like that, man. I think the new updated Disney Store lightsabers that the hilt actually comes off are like way sturdier. I might get those. I don't know. And then over here, I got this skateboard right here that I was hoping to hang up on the wall, but nah. I just can't. I can't find a way to do it. Then I got my bat right there. So if you try to break into Rocky Mountain Figures' home, you will get that bat to your face. And probably your nuts if you are a man. Before we get to the figs, I know you're all like, get to the figs! But here's some other posters that I have. Here's the Alf poster, Bumblebee poster. Or these three posters, this one, and the Captain Marvel I got from the theaters when the movies came out. And then I'm not going to get to the desk yet, but here is a Shredder painting that my brother did based on the Shredder in Hell comic book cover. So, I mean, look at that, man. That's crazy. I used to do art. I used to do, like, drawings like that, but I just lost touch with art, man. But technically, I'm still doing art with the articulated comic book art, so. Then I got this big Baby Yoda poster from, where, Target or Walmart? I think it was Target, but, oh, man. I love this thing, dude. I love Baby Yoda, man. I love Baby Yoda. He's so awesome. But anyway, this is also what I got from eCollector619, including, you know, in addition with the Infinity Gauntlet. He gave me this, which I had a t-shirt inside. My brother took it out already, but I kept the box, and I put some thumbtacks inside and pushed it against the wall. So that's why you don't see any thumbtacks. So anyway, yeah, let's get up on the shelf. All right, so we're going to start off with these smaller shelves right here. Then I'll get to the big Marvel shelf and all this madness. But let's get to this real quick. This is my Ninja Turtle shelf, my NECA Ninja Turtle shelf. This is the Ninja Turtle side right here. Look at that, man. Oh, love these NECA Ninja Turtles. I can't wait for the re-released movie figures to come out this summer. And then here's the Foot Soldiers and Shredder and Krang, man. Oh, love these, man. It sucks because I don't have Bebop and Rocksteady. I couldn't find them. I got another Puck Light up here. Same thing for up here. But this is the Power Ranger shelf. Man, it's coming along really nicely. The Yellow Ranger. Man, I love that Yellow Ranger. I'm still debating whether I should do a review on it because I had not done a review on any of the Power Ranger figures on my YouTube. But I love these figures, man. I love them. And of course, in the back, they got Lord Zedd and Goldar. I think I might get that Lord Zedd 2-pack, but I might sell that Lord Zedd. Because I don't really want it. I don't even want the updated version. That's probably going to be one I'm going to sell. So anyway, I'm going to do another cut right now and get on my table so I can show you guys all this. Well, as soon as I got on the table, some figures down there on my table fell down. So I knew that was going to happen. But anyway, let's get into this shelf. I feel really close to the shelf, and oh man, I hope I get this right. I'm probably going to be shaking the camera a lot right now. But this is my Defender shelf. This is my street level shelf right here. I got Daredevil, Elektra, Shang-Chi, and that Punisher from the Vintage Wave, man. awesome Punisher figure, especially if you pair him up with some guns from recent figures. Oh, it's focusing. It's not really focusing. But yeah, I love that guy. And then over here, got Iron Fist, Luke Cage, Sweet Christmas from the Defenders 4-pack. Speaking of, there's the Jewel figure, or Jessica Jones figure. There's Night Thrasher. He's raised up on one of those acrylic cubes that I got from Dazio Japan. I learned that they got those boxes from one of SO Hunter's videos. Again, man, big inspirations. I've been watching like almost every toy hunter, every toy reviewer for the past, ever since I was small. Always loved YouTube. Always wanted to do videos like this. And here I am, man, finally doing videos. And you guys are loving it, so I'm really happy about that. There's the Ghost Rider figure that I got from James for $25. This guy's going for like over, I don't know, but he's definitely over retail price. He's really expensive on the aftermarket. I got him for $25 at James in Lemon Grove. Make sure you visit him if you're in the area. I highly recommend it. Then there's Paladin just stuck in the corner. And right here, I tried something new as well. I got this wire and decided to put it on the figures. And it looks nice. I think close up, you can definitely see, you know, it sticking out. But from the bottom, you know, right here, when I'm sitting down in my chair, I won't tell. You know, I can't tell. So, here's Amazing Yamaguchi Spider-Man. And then I got Moon Knight right there. I love that Moon Knight figure. Man, I tried to get another one from my buddy Matthew. I think he's watching this. I don't know. Yeah, I know he subscribed to me. But he's just so expensive on the aftermarket. It's so crazy. And I can't find him anywhere for like a cheap price. I want him new in box for my friend Matthew, but I can't find it. So, especially since he's graduating from high school this year, man. I really want to get him a new Knight, but I just can't find one. And then here's Dagger flying from Cloak. And of course, I got the Thumbtack trick right there. She's on the wire, so I love that, man. Now getting to our small Fantastic Four area, starting with the Black Panther. This is the classic Black Panther right here. And I like that figure, man. I got that for $5 at Walmart, dude. I think that was, that's literally my only SoCal collector level score right there. But anyway, here's the rest of the Walgreens exclusive Fantastic Four figures. See, Invisible Woman has the shield from the new Invisible Woman. And I got Nick and Namor. He just has the trunks on. I don't want that Walgreens exclusive. I think this one fits the rest of the shelf fine. This is like a more classic shelf right here. Like classic heroes and villains. So I think this works out pretty well. And I told you guys where I was going to put that candle that I told you about. It's right there. There's the candle right there. It's on my Think figure. And Human Torch. I didn't even point him out. He's on the Thumbtack. In the back right there. Anyway, moving on to my Avengers shelf, which I think is probably the most packed shelf here, which I don't like. I'm trying to stray away from doing like packed shelves. So that's why most of the poses you see are going to be like more simple poses. The more extreme dynamic poses are going to be up in the air. Actually, speaking of up in the air, I didn't even mention Silver Surfer, dude. One of my favorite figures of all time, bro. He's on a bunch of wires. But yeah, look at that. Boom. I love that Silver Surfer. And I tied him down with the wire too. So yeah, I forgot to mention him. Before I get to the rest of the figures at the top right here, let's get to the figures in the back. There's Falcon. Thor is on a stand. Hanger stand. There's Wasp and the Hulk figure. And in the corner right there, I wish I can raise her up more. Hoping to get some more boxes from Dazio Japan very soon, but there is the She-Hulk figure. I decided to keep her maybe up until Hasbro makes an updated She-Hulk that's classic. But anyway, speaking of classic, let's get to the Vision figure. He's also on a Thumbtack. Nothing new with this Vision there. I love the way I did this, so I'm just keeping this up there. And hey, you know, if it ain't broke, don't fix it, right? And then there's a Captain Marvel that I also got for James for $10. She came with both head sculpts. That's all I wanted, man. All I wanted. And here is the Scarlet Witch figure from the 3-pack. She's also on a hanger stand. Not sure if you guys are catching that.
There you go. A little better look right there. Look at that. Boom.
So, now let's get to the rest. There's Iron Man, and then there's Hawkeye, Wolverine, Black Panther, Ant-Man, and of course the 80th anniversary Captain America right there. Plus, my new all-time favorite female figure from Marvel Legends, the new Black Widow figure. I mean, look at that head sculpt, man. It's beautiful, dude. I love that head sculpt, and the figure itself just overall is a nice-looking figure. Came with a great amount of accessories, so I'm glad to have her, man. It was hard to find her. I couldn't even find her at Walmart. I just picked her up at James for $25, which is automatic steal. And next to my favorite female of all time is my previous favorite female figure of all time, the Psylocke figure. I still love this figure. It's my second favorite female figure of all time. I mean, come on, dude. This figure is awesome. I love it. I'm still debating whether I should get the Diamond Select one and just mod that and replace it, but I don't know. I'm starting to think I won't, just because I love this one. Anyway, getting to the back right there, you got Bishop, Iceman, Nightcrawler. Finally added Nightcrawler to the X-Men shelf. He's been on my desk for a while, so, you know, I finally added him. Then there's Storm on a thumbtack. She's kind of looking too much down. I wish I could fix that, but the hair and thumbtack, they're just, I don't know, gravity. It doesn't like me. There's the Rogue figure, once again, and it's kind of the same pose as always. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Same thing for this Archangel. And same thing for this recent Beast figure. I recently tried this a long time ago, and I just loved it. So what I did was, I stuck two thumbtacks in between his toes and put them on the top of the ceiling. And there you go. I have them upside down, man. I love it. I love it a lot. Moving on. Back to this X-Men shelf. I love this X-Men shelf, man. I mean, look at that. If I can lean back as much as I can, because I am literally on the edge right now.
Edge walking.
I don't understand that meme. But, yeah, look at that X-Men shelf. Boom, dude. Ah, X-Men. X-Men took me a while to build up. I had the Avengers. I had the Fantastic Four. But X-Men, you know, when I started Marvel Legends collecting in 2014, all I had for X-Men was like the black suit, Magneto, the Apocalypse Wave, and Old Man Logan. But now times have changed. I finally have all the X-Men figures. Man, I love it, man. There's the Wolverine, the 3-pack Wolverine. Oh, I love this. One of my favorite legends as well. And I think I already mentioned the Cyclops, the beautiful Jean Grey figure that's so expensive on the aftermarket. And I'm glad I got it for retail price. You know, the only one I sold off was the Cyclops. I just couldn't keep it. I sold that one quick, though. Like, as soon as I listed it, some guy on offer was like, "Hey, bro, you selling it?" I'm like, "Yeah." "Can I get it?" I'm like, "Sure." But then there's Professor X figure right there. Oh, look, it's sweet. I love this Professor X figure. And then here is the Colossus figure from Diamond Select. I know the Marvel Legends one looks great. I've seen it in person, but I'm not interested. I was always interested in this one. Same thing for the Diamond Select Juggernaut. I think the Diamond Select Juggernaut, most of the Diamond Selects that I have up here have been some of my first figures ever. My dad just got me a bunch of these Diamond Select figures, and I never knew where he got them from. So, you know, I think the only ones that I actually like bought for myself were this these new X-Men figures, man. And I did actually mod my Rogue right there. So, in case you guys were wondering, I believe there's mod videos online, so I'm not really going to do a mod video. But somebody should do a mod video on the Diamond Select Psylocke. Nobody has done it. They only show off what the aftermath looked like. I hate that. Just show off how you did it. Or rather, tell us how you did it, man. So annoying, dude. I hate people that just keep their secrets. We want them. But anyway, there's the beautiful Walgreens exclusive Mystique that I got for $14 when they were on sale. And then, of course, Omega Red. And then there is a Juggernaut, as I mentioned previously. Previously on X-Men. I actually was watching X-Men the anime series. I'm trying to binge all the 90s Marvel cartoons, man. I'm trying to binge them all. So what am I on? I'm on Iron Man right now, the Iron Man show. I finished X-Men and Spider-Man seasons 1-3. I'm going to watch Iron Man, Fantastic Four, Silver Surfer, then finish off, you know, Spider-Man and X-Men. But there's the Sauron. Of course, instead of using rubber bands, I use thumbtacks, wiring, and whatnot. He still looks great. Once again, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Then Sabretooth right in the middle. It's supposed to, like, parallel how Wolverine is. You know, right in the middle. So, I have him right in the middle. And of course, I got Magneto just, like, using his magnetism powers, bro. I love that Magneto figure. Then here's the Deadpool figure on my villain shelf. Because I think originally he started off as a villain. And in the Hulk vs. Wolverine movie, he was a villain. Or one of the antagonists. There's Mr. Sinister, Apocalypse, Silver Samurai. And funny story about this guy. I kind of just threw him up there. I still like how he is. I actually got him on two thumbtacks. One on his hand and one on his foot. What happened was, when I finally finished this whole shelf, I totally forgot about my newly built Wendigo, man. I totally forgot about it. It was just sitting on my computer. I was like, oh, I didn't add him? So I just quickly added him up there. But I still like how he looks. He's kind of crossing over with the Avengers because I believe he's fought everybody. So it kind of makes sense still. But anyway, here is the Doctor Doom figure. Oh, man. I love this figure a lot, dude. This figure's amazing. Then, before we get to the other ones, there's Thanos, the Walmart exclusive. Then there I got the Diamond Select Abomination. I'm hoping to do that mod that everyone's doing where they're putting the head for this guy on the Gamerverse one. So yeah, I'm hoping to do that. And James still hasn't gotten the Abomination figure from the Wave, so I don't think he will. But, you know, I'll probably get something else. It's got a lot of stuff, so a lot of potential. There is Ultron, the Diamond Select Ultron on a thumbtack. Once again, it's from my dad. Most of the Diamond Selects here, as mentioned before, are from my dad. Thank you a lot, Dad. Really appreciate it. Then I got Super Skrull on a thumbtack with the head. You know, it's right there. Ooh, I almost hit Carnage. I'm very scared because, like, if you keep messing with the thumbtack over and over again, it's going to get loose and it's going to fall down. So I'm hoping not to touch too many of these figures. Don't mess them up. There's Baron Zemo with Angela's sword. Because the sword that he has, I tried to fix it and broke. Or it didn't break. Just the paint just looks horrible. So this Winter Soldier. This Winter Soldier, man. Everyone was like, bruh, I don't want that Winter Soldier. Next thing you know, he sold out everywhere. I think I sold him, too. I sold an extra one that I got. So, hey, man. Don't underestimate a figure, dude. Just chill out, wait till it comes out, and see what you think. Same thing for this Crossbones, man. Everyone's kind of hating on this. People are still kind of hating on it because of the body mold. But I think it works for this figure. And besides, they added a lot of new stuff. So I like this Crossbones. And plus, he sold out everywhere, too. But the Build-A-Figure, man. Ooh, yes. The Build-A-Figure is so awesome. I love this Build-A-Figure. Going down, we're starting to head to the street level villains. Here we got Bullseye, then we got Taskmaster, and Tombstone, Black Cat. I kind of wish I got the classic version of Black Cat, but this will do my shelf justice. And then Kraven, and then of course in the back right there, the big boy himself, Kingpin. Man, I love that one. I'm still debating whether I should get the new one that's coming out. I don't know if I want to get it and put the Shadow King head on this one or keep that Kingpin on card, or most likely I'll probably just buy to resell it. But yeah, and he's also on a cube right there. So, and then here is the Red Skull. He was on a thumbtack. You know, he's kind of like the gateway into it, or the gateway into the villain shelf. Oh man, I almost hit these guys. Actually, I'll show you this real quick. My brother still kept his Gundams up here on these rubber bands. I didn't take it down because he didn't say anything, so I'm going to leave those up there for him. Man, we still have a long ways to go, dude. It's been like, or this clip so far is 18 minutes, which I'm pretty sure combined with the other clips, whew, it's going to be a while, man. Sorry, guys. I'm going to edit this video as much as I can, but yeah, we still got a lot to go. I'll try to go faster right now. I'm just talking a lot, man. There's a lot of story behind these figures, and I just want to share it with you guys, man. I know I talk a lot, but I just want to share. I know you guys are probably like, get to the figures! We want to see the figures! I'm like, dude, you know, let me talk about them real quick. I'm talking about my history, because each figure, you know, brings me a different type of joy. Each figure has a different story behind them. Some of them I don't remember. Some of them I do. Some of them I appreciate more than others because they were gifts, such as the Diamond Selects. Some of them I bought myself, and I went through a lot of trouble to buy them. So, you know, I just want to tell those stories. Anyway, here's Green Goblin right there with Shocker, and then Dr. Octopus on the side. Come on, focus! Speaking of, Doc Octopus, or Doc Ock, only has three of his tentacles because I took one off just because it got in the way. So it looks nicer like this anyway. It's kind of like grasping onto the edge of the shelf. Not really, though. I wish the arms were articulative or had some articulation in them. Just kind of disappointment, but still is a great figure. Lizard is just chilling in the back, the bath. My bath has some defects, like the arm right there. It doesn't pop all the way in for some reason. So, you know, it keeps falling off. Same thing for the head. It likes to fall off, so it's pretty loose too. So, a little disappointed in that, but it's okay. Then here I got my Mysterio figure. Once again, same thing with the Kingpin. I'm not sure if I'm going to buy it. I might just, you know, keep it on card or resell it, most likely. But I love this Mysterio. This one, it's funny because I didn't know it was going to be rare. I didn't know it was going to be super hard to find. I think I've only found them once in stores. But I bought my Mysterio off of GameStop. And, you know, without knowing he was going to be so much, he was going to be worth so much. And I got him. I was like, dude, this is awesome. I'm pretty sure no one's going to, you know, I didn't know. I was like so clueless. I just added him to the shelf. Next thing you know, I hear all the news reports saying, oh, they're scalping Mysterio. Can't find Mysterio area anywhere. And I'm like, whoa, dude. I just got one of the rarest figures without any effort. Man, that's crazy. Then there's my Diamond Select Rhino. And figures in the background. Electro. Scorpion. And then Vulture. He's actually on three thumbtacks. Two of them are on his wings. Another one on the foot. That way he doesn't hang and, you know, put any more stress on the thumbtacks. But I love this Vulture, man. I know a lot of people are kind of like, eh, it's okay, Vulture. But I love it, man. And this is one of my favorite things. I put wire. This actually took a while. I'm never going to take this down, even for a picture. But I actually put the wire on Venom and Carnage. And, man, it took a lot of effort. But I got them up there. I got them like they're fighting, you know. Like they're about to kill each other or, you know, beat up each other. I got the inspiration after watching the Spider-Man animated series 90s episode. So, man. This clip is already 20 minutes. I'm pretty sure we're like over 40 minutes if I combine all the clips. Once again, I'll edit it down to the last atom if I can. But we're going to get to this. So over there, I got some more candles holding up the figures. I got that candle idea after seeing Mike the Hunter shove. Like, I think some of his figures were raised up by those candles, by those Bed Bath & Beyond candles. So, you know, I decided to do the same thing. Once again, I love getting inspiration from other people, from other YouTubers and other Instagrammers and whatnot. But anyway, here is the shelf, the X-Force shelf. It's coming along nicely, especially with the Boom Boom and the Cannonball that I got up there. That's really nice. And I got my up-and-coming X-Factor right here. It's pretty small, pretty unnoticeable. When I get that strong guy, bro, yeah, that's going to be what this is going to make the shelf look awesome. But I got the Quicksilver, Forge, Havoc. I think the Havoc and Polaris were literally the first two-pack or first figures I bought from James. Next thing you know, I went into another black hole. Anyway, getting to my Guardian shelf or my Space Hero shelf, there's my movie Rocket figure, my old movie Rocket figure, my old movie Drax figure, and then my old movie Star-Lord figure with the new head sculpt on. And I only put these because the comic book characters, they pretty much represent these looks now. They pretty much take these looks. And besides, that's not even like a Dave Bautista head. That's before face printing time, so, you know, it can still work as a comic book character, you know? Then, of course, right here, I got Iron Man, who leads his way into the Iron Man's shelf, but we'll get to that in a second. I got Vance Astro, Angela, Beta Ray Bill, I got the two Novas, and Nighthawk, or Darkhawk. Which I don't know where he, I don't really know much about that character. I just kind of put him in the space shelf. But I think if when I get that rage, I'll probably put him in the Defenders. And then I got my Cosmic Ghost Rider. This is actually the first figure that I tested the wire on, and I love it, man. I love it a lot. Especially the light that hits the skull. And of course, if you get it right, look at that. Boom. The globe lights up. And of course, when the light hits the back. Dude, this is just the perfect spot for this guy, man. I really worked on this, too. This guy worked on so hard to get up there, and I got him up there, man. So now getting to the Iron Man shelf. You know, this Iron Man's between the Guardians and the Iron Man just because he's a Guardian of the Galaxy armor. But at the same time, he's in the Iron Man shelf, so kind of leads into the Iron Man. So there's the Mark 7, one of, probably my second or third favorite Iron Man figure. There is the Invisible Iron Man. I also love that. Also probably second or third place. Behind 80th anniversary. And this is actually probably one of my first Legends figures. You know, of course, I got this as a little kid. And, yeah, I just kept it all these years. I didn't even know he was a Marvel Legends. Anyway, there's some War Machine. There's three War Machine figures in the back. The Hulkbuster from the 2-pack. And this is so out of place, so odd. These guys are supposed to be on, like, the sides of Hulkbuster. But with the shifting and moving of the shelf, they just kind of moved to the side. But yeah, I got the two Civil War and Homecoming suits right there. And we are going to get into the Spider-Man shelf. Again, I used the wire technique. And I got the symbiote Spider-Man with the Red Goblin figure. And this Spider-Man shelf is pretty much a combination of the symbiotes and the Spider-Verse. So yeah, I didn't want to do a separate one this time. So there is all the Spider-Man figures on the shelf. And plus Scream. There's the Venom Bath, and then Lasher, Dime Select Venom, Poison, Pork Grind, and there's all the Spider-Man figures right here. I'm not even going to point them out. I'm just going to, you know, focus, hopefully, and you guys can point them out. The only ones I will point out is probably this one. This is my favorite Legends figure of all time. At least until the new Spider-Man figure comes out. And then the MCU figures, man. Ooh. We're getting close. All we really have is this section. And then I'll go over my table real quick after I set those girls up. But, yeah, we're almost done, man. Almost done. God, I'm sorry if you guys are going to be watching. For those of you watching, man, you guys are real ones, bro. But if you're just, like, getting bored, I'm sorry for making this long again. You know, I'll edit it down as much as I can, but here is the Guardians of the Galaxy MCU shelf. And of course, as you guys know, I got this Gamora figure from just Jay Hernandez himself. That's for real, dude. I actually got it from him. You know, in case you guys think I'm lying, I'm not, dude. In fact, I'll shoot up, I'm not going to show much more information, but I'll shoot up some DMs that I text him asking for the figure. So, there it is. And there's like kind of my Ant-Man, my Wasp setup. So I got my Giant Man that I finally complete after 5 years. Finally completed it. After five, no, 4 years, right? Came out in 2016 and we're in 2020. Yeah. And there's the Ant-Man figure right there. And then here's my kind of like the Black Panther spot. Got M'Baku Bath. I got the Dora Milaje. Then I got Shuri right here. And then one new addition that I added was Yelena Belova. Here's Spider-Man, the Homecoming. I didn't get the Far From Home suit. Because that one's not really good. There's Vision, Scarlet Witch, War Machine, and Rescuer in the back right there. There's a lot of thumbtack spots right there, man. From previous stuff. Also, there's Captain Marvel, just before I forget. Here, let me get on the back. There's Doctor Strange, Falcon without his wings. This time, I'm not going to add him with the wings, man. Just so much trouble. Plus, those wings are just getting so beat up, man. There's Valkyrie, Black Panther, Wakanda forever. Ah, man, I love this Black Panther. This is my favorite Black Panther figure right here. And then I got the OG Endgame 6 right here. Or Endgame and Infinity War. So I got Iron Man, Cap. This is the SH Figure Arts Black Widow. SH Figure Arts Ronin back there. Hulk. SH Figure Arts as well. And then Thor. Dude, this Endgame Cap, man. Whew, I love it, bro. I love it a lot, dude. And then, this is kind of leading into my villain shelf right here, as you see. But, Yeah, it kind of gets dark over here. I think there's not enough lighting on that side, so kind of gets dark. So, and the lights from the ring lights aren't even helping, so I'm going to go like this. Here's the Black Order right there. Here's Loki. Here's the rest of the villains as well. So I got like Vulture. Hela and Ultron are in the back right there. Mysterio and Vulture are next to each other. Ego and Ronin are next to each other. These three are all together as well. Red Skull, Winter Soldier, and Crossbones. Behind them is Killmonger and Ulysses Claw. Killmonger, the reason why his arm's like that is because he's about to pull out the gun. And then there's Taskmaster, dude. I love this Taskmaster figure. And then Yellowjacket back there. Yeah. How's that for quick? I don't know. We're probably like overtime right now. Oh, man. All right. I'm going to do a quick cut right now. That way I can get everything situated, but I'll be back. Okay, this is going to be probably one of my last clips for this display update. Bro, even my dogs are like, bro, just stop.
It's time to stop, okay?
This is my brother's Transformer shelf. This Transformer shelf, man, looking sweet, looking fire. Bruno did such a good job. So, let's get into it. Before I keep talking, here's a Transformer shelf. You got Megatron. Forgive me for I don't know all the names of the movie Transformers figures. I love the designs and I love these figures, but I hate those movies, man. The Bay movies just is a big L, you know, for the Transformers franchise. And that's why there's not many Transformers fans, because, you know, they immediately look to the movies, man. They don't look to, like, the actual brand itself, you know, the toys, the TV shows, the games, of video games, man. Look at the video games, dude. You know, it's for kids. Really? Play the video games, dude. Play it. I tell you right now, people are like, oh, Arkham, Spider-Man, they're awesome. But, like, play Transformers, dude. Transformers is amazing, dude. I swear, you guys won't regret it. You know, those two games are amazing. The third game, the Darkspark game, don't get that one. But just get War for Cybertron and Fall of Cybertron. Then watch the G1 shows, bro. That's all you need to do. That's all you need to know. Maybe even Transformers Prime is still awesome as well. Anyway, these are the Constructicons. And here's the rest. Here's the two Bumblebee figures. The Optimus Prime Bumblebee movie figure, which is arguably one of the best Optimus Prime figures. But I still think the new one, the Earthrise, the one I have, is still the best. Then my brother did this weird thing where... this is probably my least favorite thing on the shelf. I don't know. It's kind of moved a little bit because of, you know, me opening the drawers and whatnot. But, you know, it's supposed to be like Optimus has him in a headlock. He's about to slide, you know, cut him down like in the movie. But I don't know. I don't see it. He'll probably improve it later. But anyway, here is some more Transformers figures. And then there's a Drift. And this one. Of course, as you see, he's got some Funko Pops in the back. Some Funko Pops at the top. Down there is his $1,000 Funko Pop that went down in price, actually. Oh, man, that was a funny clip, dude. Matter of fact, play that clip right now.
Bro, that's $1,000! No, really! Let's go!
Oh, man, I love that. I love it when he got excited, dude. Oh, God, my power is 15%. All right, let's power through this. So here's some more Taranta posters right here, plus some Funko Pop Pez. And then this is an actual, you know, metal poster that I got. And then here is my desk, which, as you see now, it's bigger. Why? Because, first of all, my brother's moving out anyway. And secondly, is that how you use the phrase, secondly? Or, you know, next, he doesn't clean his desk. And I warned him, you know, 2 months ago, if he didn't clean his desk, then I would take it from him. And he didn't listen to me. He never cleaned his desk, not even once. He said he was. And even after I took over the desk, he said he was gonna clean the desk. And I said, doubt. Doubt. Big doubt. And he never cleaned his desk. In fact, I complained about it in my previous collection videos. So
this week, I cleaned his desk because he kept refusing. And I know he's pretty happy about that.
This is my brother's side, which he's a little bit more messy and does not like to clean his desk, so...
I mean, as you see there, it's like, oh my God, dude. He's never cleaned his desk once. If anything, I've cleaned it for him, and he's just taking credit for it. So wrong. And still, he never even cleans his bed either. Jesus. So anyway, getting to the figs that I have here. These are kind of like special figs that I either couldn't fit on the shelf or just close to me, you know, that I don't have room for, but I want it on my desk because they're awesome figures. So here is the Avenger bucket that I got on Endgame night, Thursday night. And I got some army builders in there. Then here's a DC Multiverse McFarlane, Harley Quinn, and Batman. Not sure if you heard that. I just cracked my neck right now. I like these figures a lot. I especially love this Harley Quinn. Harley Quinn's great. Batman is also great, but he just can't stand. Even on his stand, he can't stand. That's why he's leaning against the wall. But I am hoping to get the Trinity of armor, you know, the armored Superman, Batman, and Wonder Woman figures. And I'm also hoping to get the new Arkham game Joker and the Joker and Batman figure as well, you know. Anyway, moving along. Here we have the Diamond Select Thanos that I mentioned earlier. This one for sure, my dad got me. Here is where my 80th anniversary Hulks went. This is like my collection of Hulks right here. So I got my Gray Hulk that I got from James for about $35, I think. It was $30 or $35. That was a steal right there, man. Steal. Then I got this Hulk for about... I got him at GameStop. I think it was like... $60-something. I don't know. It's pretty expensive. I sold off the Wolverine, but I kept the Hulk. Dude. Okay, hold on a sec. Okay, I fixed her right now, but moving along. Here's my Storm Collectibles Street Fighter figures. I think these are the only Storm Collectibles I'm going to get. I'm not going to try to get into the line, but these two are all I need. Sagat is probably one of my favorite characters from the game. And then Ryu. He's Ryu, dude. You got to have him. Then here, I got my Netflix Daredevil. Rip Daredevil, man. It's been a while since season 3 came out. Daredevil is my favorite TV show, man, of all time. I love it. The writing, the cinematography, the music, the acting. It's all so stellar, dude. It's spectacular, man. Hopefully Daredevil will come in the MCU. Charlie Cox said it's not going to be his Daredevil that will come into the MCU. I hope he's just lying like Ewan McGregor when everyone kept asking him about Obi-Wan, but, we'll see. And then here is the two Black Widows that were on my Avengers show, but now are here. But I still like them both, especially the white suit Black Widow, which is getting so bright. And then the black suit, vintage wave Black Widow. I like this figure. And thing is, I finally straightened out her legs because they were, you know, this is a skinny leg, so they were like, you know, warped inwards. I finally fixed it, and next thing you know, as soon as I fix it, I have to replace it with the white suit Black Widow. And as soon as I get the white suit Black Widow on the shelf, I have to replace it with the gray suit Black Widow. So crazy. We got loads of Black Widows, man. Then it's my Darth Vader coin bank right here. I always collect my quarters and pennies, man. Always. And then there's a picture of my family right there. Right there. It's a little dirty. I gotta clean that up. But it's best that you don't see that, because I know some person in here is definitely trying to steal my identity. And then here's my prize right here. My prize. Oh, man. The Baby Yoda. Oh, man. I love this one. I love it, dude. I love this Baby Yoda. Dude, look at him. He's so cute, man. He's so cute. Look at the eyes. Dude, this is all I need. I was like, bro, should I get the $60 animatronic? But I'm like, no. Get the Baby Yoda. Just this one. $25. It looks almost exactly like him. Dude, this is all you need. We're done. Literally, I'm out of breath. Oh my god. We are done, dude. We are done. Oh god. I have so much footage to cut. Let's get to the outro real quick. Literally, I'm sweating, dude. I need some... sorry if you guys heard that, man. I'm thirsty, dude. I'm literally out of breath. So yeah, this is how much work I put into you guys. Oh man, for your guys' entertainment. My suffering for your guys' entertainment. I'm sorry, I'm so tired. I'm gonna be saying random things. Sorry, no, I don't mean that. I love doing these videos, man. I love doing these videos. I've always wanted to be a YouTuber and take pictures of my toys, and I'm finally doing it, dude. I'm almost at 1,000 followers from the time of recording this, and
when I get there, I'm doing a giveaway, another giveaway, man. You know, stay tuned for that. Keep an eye out on my Instagram if you guys are interested. Oh, man, I'm so happy. So happy I finally finished and finally done this video. Man, this took a while, about over a month. Ever since this whole quarantine started, I really went to work. I went to town, got everything that I needed for this video. I spent a lot of money, you know, not just on the figures, but, you know, on all the stuff that I needed to create this video. So I want to thank you guys for also making this possible with my eBay and OfferUp. Once again, that money's just going into the channel, you know, so very happy about it. Thank you guys. Thank you guys that are watching for watching. I really appreciate it. A lot of my past display videos have gotten over 1,000 views, which is crazy because I'm at the time of this recording, I'm almost at 400. So like, what? Like, who are these people? Man, these people are coming in, watching my videos. They're like, dude, you're awesome. I'm like, thank you, bro. You know, and I think my hair's a little messy. And I think those guys are like the reason why I'm getting more subscribers. Because I see other channels that have been on like YouTube for 2-3 years and they only have like 100, 200 subscribers. And I've only been here for almost 1 year and I got 400 subscribers. That's a big come up, man. That is crazy. So I just want to thank you guys for helping me out and for supporting the channel and supporting my Instagram, man. I really appreciate you guys. Oh my God, we're about to run out of time. Well, this is going to be the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, feel free to leave a like, comment, subscribe, follow my Instagram. Go check out my eBay and OfferUp. Links to all those three will be in the description below. And yeah, man, I hope you guys did enjoy this video. I appreciate you guys for watching. I love you guys. I'll see you guys next time.